Hi, my name is Olena, and during the next videos, I'll be your guide building a movie recommendation project. Our goal? To create a system that suggests movies closely aligned with a user's search query. Our project will rely on multiple building blocks. First of all, we'll use Postgres and PGVector for vector-based searches. Secondly, we'll use TensorFlow library and its model to encode our movies into the vectors. And lastly, bringing it all together will be the job of Node.js and Next.js. Now, I'll assume that you do have some familiarity with Node.js and willingness to tackle any challenges that come our way. No worry though, I'll be walking you through each individual step, and I also have a bunch of links with additional materials to fill in any knowledge gaps you might have. Not to mention that I would encourage you to leave any comments below with questions or doubts so that I can help you straight away. Also, don't hesitate to leave any suggestions or ideas you might have. Maybe you see how we can do certain things better and faster. This course has two-part structure. First, we are laying down the basics by creating embeddings with TensorFlow and PGVector with Node.js to get those recommendations. For the first part, we'll keep it simple with just JavaScript and no UI yet. Once we've nailed that, it's time to level up and we'll introduce Next.js, then integrate, route API calls, and design a more friendly user interface for entering movie descriptions and getting the recommendations. We'll use a bit of Tailwind CSS for that. Rest assured, we are going to be very budget-friendly with the tools we are using, so that you can follow me at zero cost. We'll be working with open-source Postgres running smoothly on the cloud for free. We'll be running a model from TensorFlow locally, and it works well across different machines, though I must admit that TensorFlow JavaScript library has its character, and it can be quite stubborn from time to time. However, I will share with you what exactly you need to pay attention to avoid those unnecessary hours of debugging, which I had. So, are you ready to embark on this adventure with me? Let's dive in and start building something exciting together.